me again, Gray. Yeah, I'm a headbanger from England, and I've been checking out music from around the world, basically. That's the aim on this kind of section of my channel. I do lots of stuff on my channel, but this reacting to like music I'm not normally familiar with is one of my most recent ventures. And I've been helped actually by this commenter who's sent me loads of good ones to check out. Depi Zizuri, is that Zixuri? I'm not too sure I pronounced his channel name, but he's been sending me loads of cool ones to check out, and he comments on all my videos as well, tells me more about the band. So I'm learning a fair bit. Today I've got a band called Los Fabulosos Cadillacs. So that's got to be the Fabulous Cadillacs, isn't it? A track called El Satanico Dr. Cadillac. So I don't know, is it the Dr. Satan's Cadillac or the Cadillac of Satan or something like that? I'm not too sure, but when I see that Cadillacs in the name of a band, I think rock and roll, because I do a 50s podcast with my dad. When I was doing my heavy metal podcast, High Speed Hangover, every month I do a podcast with my dad. It's a Catman Jack's 50s Hop. The link is down below if you want to check out his latest show. And the rock and roll bands are always like quite a lot of bands called Cadillacs, quite a lot of songs of Cadillac in the title. So when I see Los Fabulosos Cadillacs, I'm guessing it's going to be a kind of like a rock and roll band. But obviously with a South American flavour, a Latin flavour, I'm sure. But let's just find the video and give it a watch. That's not rock and roll. That's funky, man. That is funky. Some funky bass. I'm kind of kicking myself because I need to find better videos to react to. Not the song's fine, the song's perfect, but this is just like a picture of the band with a song going over it. I wish I found the live version so I could see what the band was up to, what kind of instruments they were playing. I'm picking up the bass, definitely some funky bass lines going on there. I actually should have learned my lesson. I did a reaction to Lorenga, a band called Lorenga, and that was a similar thing, just an image with a song going over it. And someone said to me, oh, you should find the live. You're much better to see them live, to see everything going on, the echo. And I said, yeah, cool, so why didn't I think of that? And now I've chosen this one, and I've got like another version that hasn't got any live stuff going. I should have looked for live. I'll have to remember that in future, but I've started it now, so I've started the reaction, I've got to finish it. But yes, it's a cool, funky Latin. It's, I don't know what it, I mean, I don't even know the difference of the music. It's not tango or samba, or, but it's definitely like, it's like kind of like disco funky kind of stuff in certain elements, with like obviously more music familiar to the local area, I suppose, the Latin rhythms and all that, mixed in with some disco funk kind of sound. And yeah, it's interesting. And like the interplay between the backing vocals and the main singer is quite cool as well. I feel I've got a bit of trumpet at some point. At one point, I definitely heard a little bit of brass section there. And it's one of those ones, I'm a headbanger, but you can't deny when there's some rhythm going on that just gets you going, you know? Even if it's not really my cup of tea, not something that I would check out on the normal. It's got that infectious groove to it, you know? You can't help but to you know, move your body. The end bit there. Yeah, da-da-da. That was interesting. That was cool. I was kind of interested in what kind of percussion they had going on. Obviously, you could hear a drum kit, but it also sounded like it was like a constant bop, bop, like a kind of wooden block or something like that. Was the drummer doing that? Was that a separate instrument? And there was a couple of, like, noises as well, like, I don't know what they were, like, sort of, I don't know, weird, like, just little sort of noises in the background there, like, I don't know, maybe some kind of Latin instrument, I have no idea what it is, I don't know, there were some other little noises going on there that were unidentifiable to me anyway. Maybe if I'd seen a live show of it, I would have had a better idea of what the instruments were, but that was cool, that was interesting. Yeah, it started off like nice funky rhythm, it changed up a little bit along the way, and yeah, it was cool. Definitely a foot tapper, definitely one to get your get your body moving as much as my poor old man body can move, you know. Oh, too much head banging over the years, I've got to take it easy. The old back's not what it used to be, but yeah, that was interesting. I'm just looking at this day, there's six people in the band, looking at the picture of them. Just trying to think, I mean, obviously a bass player. The bass player was funky, man. There's some bass going on. Some bass rhythms were kind of like the driving force of the track, I suppose, giving it that you know, you know, quite a good drum kit. And there was that sounded like a wooden block beat, a cowbell maybe. Was he playing a cowbell at the same time? As he was doing the rest of the drums, maybe there was another person doing different percussive instruments, I'm not sure. Some cool trombones. Trombones or trumpets, maybe. I don't know. Which is just a wind instrument of some variety. Or a brass wind instrument of some type. That was cool. But yeah, and I'm wondering how many people did the singing as well. Was it one singer? And then everyone else does the backing. But yeah, it was. I've no idea what the song was about. I didn't catch any words. I like the ending. The ending was quite cool. It caught me out a bit. It's like a diligent and it came back for a little reprise kind of thing. That was kind of like, yeah, that was a bit different. A bit different from the usual diligent, you know, quite often most will end with. It was cool though. I'm not sure what else I could say about it, to be honest. It was interesting. I'm guessing, I think it's Argentinian. A lot of the bands I've been saying have been Argentinian. I don't know if anyone wants to send me some of how similar the Argentine sound is to the rest of South America. I mean, are bands in Brazil doing the same thing? I learned a little bit about a track that I reviewed last night. I'll react to the two yesterday. He said it was like a mixture of the highlands, because you've got the Andes, like Peru, and I think Argentina as well, and like the traditional music that they sort of do there, and it was mixed in with electronic music. So obviously, I'm assuming there's a fusion of different styles as well, and maybe this is a fusion of different styles as well. I'm not too sure, or if this is just because it wasn't quite rock and roll, was it? I suppose maybe Latin rock and roll or Latin just rock. Really? Now, what kind of music do you call that, guys? Let me know more about the band. Let me know what I'm missing. Let me know what I need to learn in the comments down below. And if you've got any suggestions for any other bands for me to check out. But yeah, that now gets a thumbs up from me. That was cool. I enjoyed that. Thanks for watching, and check out my other videos if you're interested. Got lots of stuff, like comic books and stuff like that. If you like comic books, check out my comic book videos. Anyway, till next time. Thanks for watching.